try that again. 3, 2, 1, go. If I make it through Goldfish 1, this is going to be a no reset. Goldfish 1, the level where you now need to get hit by a car at the end to world record in.
I haven't gone for petrol in days. What if another one blows up?
One at your council said it was a freak accident. It was the middle of the night and no one was there. Wasn't some idiot lighting a cigarette?
That's worse though, isn't it? That means nobody blew up a petrol station. It just went
off. I randomly fall over here way more than I should. Really? Wonderful. A lot of levels I still need to practice. Make a no trash mod in this game so people can play it without the trash. I think the world needs that. Maybe no cars mod. He's gonna have such a bad day. Such a bad week.
My bucket! My bucket!
Didn't see my time. It's really weird seeing the RTA times. I think they're a little different than the IL times. You made the jump and there was no suitcases again. That's so weird. Like, I just proved that there were suitcases. I wonder why. There's something there. There's something we still have to understand. Yeah, I'd still like to see you just making the jump. I mean, I skipped all the checkpoints when I was demoing it just now, too. No, the changes, I mean, we're playing on the same version of the game, but the changes that I made was literally just the function for getting the variable for the fishes. The fish has a property called in water, and normally it does some calculation to check if you're in water, but I just changed it to, well, it's actually really hard to talk and play at the same time. I changed, it's good practice for that. I just changed it to always return true, so that whenever it checks if you're in water, it's just you're always in water. That's the only change that I made. And then I recompiled the DLL. So I didn't do anything too crazy. I literally just changed one line. So it's not related to that. I can't imagine I'm playing on different versions or anything. If there is, I went into all the same water sources that you did. I went into... I skipped checkpoints until I went into the first bucket. and there weren't any of the other suitcases spawns that you need to do the jump. And I don't think jumping into any of those suitcases would stop them from spawning. No, wait, I skipped from checkpoint, and everything was there, and I just floated over, so... It would have been the same if I flew. I don't know why it's different. I have no idea. It shouldn't be. By everything that I can tell. I'm gonna get hit by this car. That's all. Oh, I'm not. That's good. Send me the video, though. I'm gonna dig into it a little more. So I've heard a lot of the code that does the suitcase spawning. I'll try to figure something out. Because I think it'd be amazing to see somebody do it. Yeah, it sounds difficult. Like, it sounds so difficult, I couldn't imagine it actually being possible. When you told me that it was possible, I couldn't believe it.
I'm just in pepper ash for the day. Great weather to come see the Wild Out Ridge. I live over
in Yellington. I hate the jar so much.
I've been meaning to go to Yellington Market for ages. I hear there's this new Avo fruit thing.
Oh yeah, I saw Doris eating one the other day. It has this huge stone inside it.
I wonder if there's even a setup for that skip in Goldfish 3, or if it's just physics nonsense.
Yep. The Wild Old River goes way up onto the moors. Hard to believe it runs up out of the channel.
I have no practice with the jar, so I'm going to be doing braking turns. I mean, if it could be done with consistency, I wouldn't be surprised. I just wouldn't be surprised either way. I wouldn't be surprised if you can do it consistently. I wouldn't be surprised if it's just completely random physics nonsense. And it's just like a matter of how the wind is blowing and how the jar breaks and what Unity decides gravity is at that exact minute. I mean, if you can get it with any consistency in it, it's probably more than just luck. But who knows how these, you know, jars break. Yeah, if you got it 3 times in a row, then it's probably more than just dumb luck. There's probably... We could probably find a setup for it. No, come on. I hate the jar so much. I have to practice with it. I haven't gotten any practice with the jar. I don't mind the rest of Goldfish 3, I just hate the jar. That's it. I just don't want to use the jar. This section would be super easy with a fishbowl. Look at this. Look at what nonsense the jar does. I have yet to get a good run on Goldfish 3 because I have not practiced at all. I'm not fast enough at this level to even know that Scotty can give you problems. He's never given me problems because I'm not fast enough to see them. Now, I will at some point sit down for days and just grind Goldfish 3. But today, I just want to finish it without dying too many times. I didn't know there was a skip that had anything to do with Scotty or in the entire Scotty section. What's the skip? No, see this way, the fucking jar. Seeing Moto's latest Piranha 1, where he's just blazing fast with the jar, was just insane, and even he, like, messes up sometimes. Oh, interesting. I've never seen that before. I don't even remember how to end this level early. But then I don't actually remember how to end it normally either. So I'm just gonna go to the end of this platform and run off of it. I think that should do it, right? Pretty for sure if I just go to the end here and run off, I'll be fine. Something like that. Oh, come on. Don't do this to me. Fall in the water. Fall in the water. Fall in the water. Fall in the water. Alright. That's like my hardest level, actually, so it's nice to have that out of the way. I've practiced Finale a lot. I've practiced Flying Fish 3 a bit. I've practiced Pufferfish 3 a lot. I haven't practiced the new strat a lot, but that's fine. Yeah, I can see that happening. It's probably easy for me, because I was just doing, Yeah, that's true. It was really exciting when it was discovered, too. We were racing to see who can get something in with the new strat first. We submitted videos at the exact same time, but his was 30 seconds faster because I screwed up a bit with the crowd at the end. And then it turns out you can just run through the crowd. Really? I'm gonna break right there? Really? All the jars in this game, all the vehicles, actually have a hidden health meter. The fish doesn't, but the jars do. No, okay.
Yeah, the jar in Finale, I don't even want to think about it.
Like, the jar is hard enough in an open road. Trying to use the jar on a table with obstacles, it just sounds awful. Now, if this cannot break when hitting padding, that'd be great. Here we go. Now we're getting somewhere. Did you go for the new out-of-bounds skip in Puffer 2 during your run? I didn't check. I didn't get to see it. Did you do the new Puffer 2 skip? Did you get it first try? Second try. It's tricky. I tried it once. I got it third try. I swear to God, half of the struggle is just not aggroing the bird. We'll get better at it, though. You should be nicer to yourself. You got a world record and got sub 140. That's all you're going for, wasn't it? No. Did you want sub 130 a few hours ago? Well, you got sub 140. You got sub 130 next time. But you should probably start practicing IELTS. Like, specifically the ones that are late into the run. Because those are the ones you get the least practice with. The code for the water flow that moves you towards something in a lake is so complicated. I can't even begin to understand it. It's just a lot of math. I don't think I'm gonna get this. I might get this. Not bad. Two, and I am going to go for the new out of bounds skip, even though I've only done it once, because why not? But does YouTube have a size limit? Oh, I'm not even recording right now. Can you pull videos from Twitch? Can you download your own Twitch videos? Oh, you're talking about the other thing. This uploaded YouTube is unlisted. Oh, come on, come on. No thorns, please. I'm gonna have to figure out how to get this off of Twitch so I can put it up on YouTube. Guess it'd be more important to record it if I were a world record contender, but since this is my first time doing them all in a row, that's not gonna happen right away. Thank you. I think sub 2.5 is realistic. Whoops. Force of habit. I accidentally did a mega jump here last time and messed it up. Are there any places where it saves any time? I couldn't find any places where it saves any time. Because you actually take longer falling back down. So you're not rolling as much, you're in the air longer. So I think mega jumps here would actually lose time. Am I really gonna die? Really? Okay. That's just the devs messing with me. That's okay. Yes, it is fun. That's undeniable. A little time save. Alright, now for the hard part. The freaking jar. The jar is my enemy. If I ever stop running this game, it's gonna be because of the jar. Let's see if I can get over here without aggroing the birds. One day I will sit here and grind this level along with the other levels. Stay away from me, birds. No aggro. Oh. I'm just gonna sit for a second and wait for... Come on, go down. Why are you still yellow? If the bird hits you in this area, it just ruins everything. Oh no. Okay, wait for the bird aggro to go down. Go down just a little more so I can safely get over this piece of weird geometry. You need to build momentum here. This is so tricky. And we're good. We pulled it off. The birds cannot ruin it now. There we go. We did it. We need names for our skips. What is this? We can't call this puffer skip because we already have puffer skips. Yeah, first try. A little slower than it can be done, but still faster than doing everything else. And now we just have to complete the rest of the level with no checkpoints. It's great because I actually don't remember where everything is. I've only done this a couple of times. So I'm about to just run directly into thorns. Are you kidding me? Alright, we're safe. Now we don't need checkpoints. I really wish there was a faster way through this section. These little sections that are just like a solid minute of swimming. You can get a little speed boost just by jumping a lot. I'm not even sure if we can. Fisherman skip has gotten a lot easier since we discovered mega jumps. There's the fisherman. I always lose him. Now a level that I know. Yeah, I don't know how waterfall boosts work either. Everything in this game is random. Sometimes it can feel random. Like I said, the water flow mechanics are just super complicated. It's crazy to think the first time I did this level fast, it was 801. It's about 30 seconds. What is lurk? What does that mean? I missed my turn because I was looking at chat. Ah, you're taking off then? Yeah, thanks for hanging out. Talk to you later, man. Thanks. We'll see you in the verifications list tomorrow. You can catch up on what you missed. Have a good night.
draw another neck.
We're in the queue for the toilet, mate. Sod off.
Chug, chug, chug.
Hey! What did you put in that pint? What's the matter, Greg? Go and handle your drink.
Poor Greg.
Toilets need to find toilets. Toilets need to find toilets. Me.
So, who buys a fish as a moving-in present? How do we top that? It's such an awesome gift.
So awesome.
Next time they move, we'll go big.
Thank you.
just have to live with this, I guess. Okay, that's not so bad. Now, if only I can remember where to go on this level, since this is only my third time playing it, and I always forget where the buttons are.
Colin Burke, Foster Labs report number 359. How did Dr. Robert not predict this? He should have known Fox would eventually gain sentience. Now they've escaped labs and began living across Barnardshire. No knowledge of what they're supposed to be. They were made for surgery. They were made to let anyone become a surgeon. And I'll be damned if my son Colin Burke. We still have a couple of bobs down in labs. And the most peculiar thing happened. One of the blood vials seemed to almost come alive when a bomb was near. After a few more tests, it would seem Dr. Robert's new blood formula might be the reason for their rise in intelligence. Incredibly short-sighted.
Oh, I forgot to try to do the skip here. It's okay.
Colin Burke, Bossa Labs report number 453. The answer was right in front of me this whole time. I took some of Bob's blood and added it to a batch of bread at my bakery. As predicted, when brought near a Bob, it practically came alive. If I could get this bread into the hands of any Bobs in Barnardshire, it'll tell me for sure that they're the Bobs made for surgery. I can track them all down. Now, the technique is not perfect. The loaf of bread seemed to have its animalistic tendencies persist even after no Bobs were around. So I must get round to fixing that. Otherwise, things could get very much out of hand.
These machines are useless. I'm gonna miss my flight.
I think I'm just going to close my eyes and pick around and fly.
There is a reminder that children's central baggage will be detected and you will be fine.
You have to buy a ticket to fly.
I just need a holiday. I must have lost my passport. It's been a rough week.
Oh my god. I haven't missed this many in a long time. There we go.
Car was a little closer than it should have been. I cannot for the life of me remember the fact that I had to do this skip. I haven't run this since I first started playing the game.
see if I remember how to do this. I'm gonna lose like 10 minutes just on this one checkpoint. Okay, one more try, and I'm just gonna do the bathroom. Come back and practice this again later. Guess we're just doing it the normal way, because I cannot remember for the life of me how to do the skip. Hey, somebody's raiding me. I don't know exactly what that means. But I think it's a good thing. Thanks for the viewers. Were you reading this game too? Playing it casually or doing speedruns? This game is super fun casually, and it's super fun as a speed game. The first time I played it, it was just so much fun to explore and figure everything out. And then getting into speedrunning it, there are actually a lot of really cool skips and stuff that we can do. Not in this level, but if you stick around, you'll see some. After this, we have Pufferfish 3 and then Finale, and there's a lot of really cool skips in Finale. Just now learning how hard it is to play and read chat at the same time. Yeah, Piranha's super fun. You said you did. I'm trying to look at the chat and see what you said while doing this at the same time. But have you done Piranha 2 and 3 yet? No, I said about to finish up Piranha. Clip into the pipe there. Go, have myself turned around for a minute. Ah, nice. All the level 3s are really fun. They're all a lot harder and a lot longer, but they're all really fun. Flying Fish 3 is probably the hardest level in the game. It certainly gives the speedrunners the most headaches. It's also, like, I think the only level that we don't have a skip for. Of some kind. But they're all fun. This whole game is fun. I don't think there's a level that I don't like. If I can just remember where the last thing is here. There it is. I haven't practiced Piranha as much as I have some of the others.
And see if we can do this fast enough to get the rest of the area. But it's really hard. And we tied instead. Wonderful. I get some trash. Okay, so I'm just gonna do this the intended way. This is about my third time doing this level, so I think I got it right. I'm not 100% sure. Definitely need more practice on this one. Guess we'll find out right now. Yeah, we got it. Didn't get the skip, but that's okay. Let's see if we can get this skip coming out of the pipe fast. Got it, and we didn't get hit by a car. Very nice. I can only get through this without getting hit by a car. Wait for this car to pass.
man. Greg Fisher. You've been in a car accident. We'll get you to Barnardshire General as soon as possible. Hey!
Two levels left. Might even get sub 2 hours. That'd be nice. That's what I want to go for. I mean, sub 2.5 would be nice. But if I could get sub 2 for my first any percent, that'd be cool. I'd be happy with that.
Who's there? You shouldn't be here. I'm practicing. Every second you keep hiding, Bob loses more blood. Come out, wherever you are.
Can never predict how these pipes are gonna fall.
Must get back to my work. I know you're around here. Is it surgery you want? Don't run! I know you're around here. Is it surgery you want?
That's the fastest I've ever done that. I know that because I got the achievement for doing it under 3 minutes. I've never gotten that before. Very cool. I want to know who over at Boss that thought this ice cube was a good idea. Like, right next to the checkpoint, and it's so difficult to jump out of. There we go. Oh, don't do this to me. Don't do this to me. Don't die. Don't die. Don't die. Seriously. Didn't even mean to reset there. Complete accident. Might have died anyway though, so it's not bad. There we go. We got one. Thank you.
don't remember where to go. That's what happens when you try to do an 80% run without practicing every level. Gotta backtrack and find it now. There it is. It's just a minute that I can save next time. One level left. And luckily it's one that I'm good at. It's one that I actually have practiced a lot. Let's see if my muscle memory still works after doing all the other ones. Doesn't work as well as I would like, but I think I'll be okay. Oh, that's not good. You're gonna need to get out of my way, little fish. You weren't supposed to get hit. Not my fault, you were in the way. You actually do get an achievement if you knock over every single fish in the entire level, though. Not an achievement I have, but it is something developers intended or expected somebody to do. Be a sub-2-hour run if I could finish this anywhere nearly as fast as I finished it before, but without being able to retry it when I mess up. need you to get out of my way, Puffer Scoop. Piranha. Speed, yes. And skips. This is, the level is called No Fish Left Behind, but we absolutely leave fish behind at every chance that we get. It's probably faster to go through this with Piranha, but the problem with that is that when you come back, you have to reset from the checkpoint, and then all of the fish are in your way while you're trying to make this jump, and I just can't do it. They are not very smart about getting out of your way. We are going to do the first elevator skip. We're not going to do the second elevator skip because it's really hard and I haven't practiced it. I'll start practicing the second elevator skip when somebody beats my world record in this level. Then I'll have to practice it. See if we got it. We did. That's elevator skip one, and we are not doing elevator skip two today. Even though it does say 35 seconds. It can be. It's certainly hard to get used to some of it. It's very physics-based, and I don't know if you've seen the other parts of the level, like when you're in the jar or when you're in the fishbowl, but you don't control the vehicle you're in, you control the fish. It's the hardest when you're in the jar, but you kind of get used to everything. It's really fun, because there's a lot of skips you can do, there's a lot of interesting tech, every fish works differently, there's a lot of variety. And there's just enough RNG and just enough difficult skill to make impressive runs really impressive to watch. See, I would jump out right now, but all these fish are in my way. I would say it's more a matter of practice than anything. It's certainly not the hardest game I've ever speedrun. This is the only part where it says no fish left behind, and we actually can't leave any fish behind because that little gate over there won't open unless all of our fish are in here. It'll tell us not to leave anybody behind, so we actually have to go get them. Looks like this is going to be sub 2 hours. That's awesome. This is my first time running a full any percent. So getting sub 2 hours is exactly what I wanted. A lot of room for improvement. Individual levels for this game are actually really good for that. Individual levels take anywhere between usually 5 to 10 minutes on average.
And you can go pretty fast in all of them. In a lot of them. But this is definitely one of those games where if you didn't really enjoy it playing it casually, you're not going to enjoy speedrunning it. Although it can be fun to watch speedruns of because of the skips and some of the tech that's used. That's it. Once I get over here, that's the end of the level. Let's see if we can jump out. Get any of the fish to jump out. I never can because they move around too sporadically.
Trust me! These fish are up to something!
Poor Greg.
Oh no!
After everything he's been through. You definitely get a lot of practice in this game just by doing individual levels over and over. We have one speedrunner in the community who has the most amazing fastest times on the levels that he's run, but he's only run about 4 levels because he just starts with one and then goes at it obsessively until he has beaten everybody's record by like a full minute, and then he submits it. So get tons of practice in that way. Yeah, that guy has, I mean, let's see, what has he been through? First, we stole his bucket. I'm pretty sure everybody did something to him. He drank piranha. Nope, forgot to hit the button. He drank piranha. I don't think flying fish did anything to him. Then he couldn't get his ticket at the airport because he forgot his passport. And then we hit him with all this water. Poor Greg. That's the run. Got sub 2 hours. Pretty happy with that. Still have a lot of time to save. The world record holder, I think, is on his way to getting a sub 130. I think if I practice some of the levels I'm bad at, I can hit 145 pretty easily. 140 pretty easily after that. Just a matter of going back and grinding the levels that I haven't played very much. I have no idea how many people in here, or if it's just this one guy talking, but thank you everybody for watching. I'll see you next time. Good night.